In this video, we're going to complete the KutaSoftware Infinite Calculus free worksheet slope at a value. So for each problem on this worksheet, we're going to find the slope of the function at the given value. Now remember, finding the slope of the function at a given value is finding the slope of the tangent line at that value. And in order to find the slope of the tangent line, we find the derivative of the function and then plug in our value to get the slope. So in number one, we're finding the slope at x equals negative 2. So the slope at the point negative 2, negative 1. Now, in order to find that slope, we're first going to find the derivative. So the derivative of y with respect to x is going to equal the derivative of x squared plus the derivative of 6x plus the derivative of 7. The derivative of x squared is 2x to the first, or simply 2x, and the derivative of 6x is a 6, and the derivative of 7 is 0, because it's the derivative of a constant. So our derivative of y with respect to x equals 2x plus 6. So based on this derivative, we can plug in any value for x along our function and get the slope. That's what the derivative tells us. So what we're going to do now is take negative 2 and plug in negative 2 for x. So that's going to be 2 times negative 2 plus 6. 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. Negative 4 plus 6 is a positive 2. So the slope in number 1 at negative 2 is positive 2. So let's go ahead and draw that tangent line just to see. So using the slope, that's a rise of 2 over a run of 1, rise of 2 over a run of 1, and so on. But we only need 2 points to make that line. So that's our tangent line, and we found the slope of our function at that point, which is the slope of the tangent line to that point. So number 2, again, we're going to find the derivative of y with respect to x. So the derivative of y with respect to x equals the derivative of x cubed, which is 3x squared, minus the derivative of 3x squared, which 2 times 3 is 6, so that's 6 times x to the first, or 6x, and then we're adding that to the derivative of 5, which is 0. So we'll just have 3x squared plus 6x. Now, in order to find the slope, at any given point, we're going to plug in the x value where we want to find the slope at. So because we're finding the slope at x equals 3, we're plugging in 3 for x. So we'll get 3 times 3 squared minus 6 times 3. So that's 3 times 3 squared is 9, minus 6 times 3 is 18. 3 times 9 is 27, and 27 minus 18 equals a positive 9. So our slope at x equals 3 is a positive 9. So using that slope, let's graph another point in order to find that tangent line, just to draw it out so you can see it visually. So as opposed to using positive 9 over positive 1, I'll use negative 9 over negative 1. So going down 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 1 to the left in the run, we'll now draw our tangent line. Let's continue on to number 3. In number 3, we're finding the slope of our function y equals x cubed minus 6x squared plus 9x minus 4 at x equals 2. So we're starting by finding the derivative of y with respect to x. So that's going to be the derivative of x cubed, which is 3x squared, minus the derivative of 6x squared, which 2 times 6 is 12. 12 times x to the 2 minus 1 is 12x, plus the derivative of 9x is 9, and then the derivative of 4 is 0. And we don't need to add or subtract 0 since that won't change the value. Now, since we're finding the slope at x equals 2, we're going to plug 2 in for x. So we'll have 3 times 2 squared minus 12 times 2 plus 9. So that's 3 times 4 minus 12 times 2 which is 24, plus 9, so that's going to give us 3 times 4 is 12, so 12 minus 24 plus 9, 12 minus 24 is negative 12, and negative 12 plus 9 is going to be a negative 3. So negative 3 is the slope of our function at x equals 2. For number 4, the derivative of y with respect to x, the derivative of negative x cubed, negative 3x squared, and I'm subtracting the derivative of 6x squared, which 2 times 6 is 12, so that will be 12x to the 2 minus 1, so 12x to the first, or 12x. And then I'm subtracting the derivative of 9x, so subtracting a positive 9, and this is a constant, so the derivative will be 0. Now I'm going to take my value of negative 4 and plug that in for x to find the slope at that point. So we'll have negative 3 times negative 4 squared minus 12 times negative 4 minus 9. Negative 3 times negative 4 squared will be negative 3 times a positive 16. And we'll subtract 12 times negative 4. So subtracting a negative is the same as adding positive. So that's going to be plus a positive 48 minus 9. Negative 3 times 16 is negative 48, so we have negative 48 plus 48 minus 9, which will equal a negative 9, because negative 48 plus 48 is 0, and 0 minus 9 is negative 9. So negative 9 is the slope of our function at x equals negative 4. And number 5, we're finding the derivative of y with respect to x, and then we'll plug in x of 2. For number 5, though, now in order to find the derivative, we're going to need to use the quotient rule. Low d high minus high d low all over low squared. So low, x squared minus 9, times the derivative of the high, the derivative of negative 1, minus high, negative 1, times the derivative of our low, x squared minus 9. And again, low is the denominator value and high is the numerator value. And that's all over low, low. So x squared minus 9 squared. Simplifying, we'll have x squared minus 9 times the derivative of negative 1 is times 0. And then we're subtracting a negative, so that'll be adding a positive, 1 times the derivative of x squared minus 9, which will be 2x, because the derivative of x squared is 2x, and the derivative of 9 is 0, so 2x minus 0 is 2x. And 2x times a negative 1 is a negative 2x, but since we're subtracting, that's going to be plus a positive 2x. And that's all over x squared minus 9 squared. Now you can see that x squared minus 9 times 0 is 0. So I have 2x over x squared minus 9 squared as my equation for my derivative. So now I'm going to take that value of 2 and plug it in for x. So I'll get 2 times 2 all over 2 squared minus 9 squared. 2 times 2 is 4, so that's 4. All over 2 squared is 4, so that's 2 squared, which is 4 minus 9 squared. So that's going to give me 4 over 4 minus 9 is a negative 5 squared. So that's going to be 4 over negative 5 squared, which is 4 over a positive 25. So 4 25ths is my solution in number 5. In number 6, we're going to again utilize the quotient rule to find the derivative of y with respect to x. Remember, that's low d high, so the denominator, x plus 5, times the derivative of our numerator, the derivative of negative 3, which is 0. So low d high minus high d low, negative 3, times the derivative of x plus 5, which is 1. Because the derivative of x is 1, and the derivative of 5 is 0, and 1 plus 0 is 1. And that's all over our denominator squared, low squared, x plus 5 squared. So simplifying, you can see that x plus 5 times 0 is 0, so I'll just be subtracting negative 3 times 1, which will be subtracting a negative 3, which subtracting a negative will be a positive, so that'll be a positive 3 all over x plus 5 squared. So this equation will give me the slope of my function at any given value. However, the value I'm using in number 6 is 1. So I'll take 1 and plug that in for x. So that's going to be 3 all over 1 plus 5 squared, which is 3 over 6 squared, which is 3 over 36. However, both 3 and 36 are divisible by 3, so that will be 1 over 12. 1/12 is my solution in number 6. In number 7, I'm going to need to use the chain rule. So I'm going to set y equal to negative u to the 1/3. That means that my u value is x plus 2. So the derivative of y with respect to u is going to equal negative 1/3 u to the 1/3 minus 1, which is to the negative 2/3. Now I'm going to take my u value of x plus 2 and plug that in for u. So I'll get negative 1/3 times x plus 2 to the negative 2/3. So I have dy to u, but now I need to find du dx. And the derivative of x plus 2 is 1. So I need to multiply dy du to du dx in order to find dy dx. So I'll have 1 times negative 1/3 x plus 2 to the negative 2/3, which 1 times any quantity is just that quantity. So dy du is also equivalent to dy dx. So rewriting this so that I don't have a negative exponent, I'll have negative 1 over 3 times x plus 2, and that's the positive 2/3. So now I'll take my value of negative 1 and plug it in for x to solve. So I'll have negative 1 over 3 times negative 1 plus 2 to the 2/3. So that's going to be negative 1 over 3 times 1 to the 2/3. So I'll have negative 1 over 3 times positive 1, which is a negative 1/3. So negative 1/3 is my solution in number 7. Now on to number 8. In number 8, I'll be using the chain rule again. You can see my outer function is u to the 1/2, and my inner function, or inside function, u is equal to negative x plus 2. So if negative x plus 2 is u, I'm going to find the derivative of y. I'm going to take this 1/2, that's going to come down in front and get multiplied to the negative, and then I'm decreasing that value of the exponent by 1. So I'll have negative 1/2 times u to the negative 1/2, because 1/2 minus 1 is negative 1/2. However, u is negative x plus 2. So that will be negative 1/2 times negative x plus 2 to the negative 1/2. And now I'll multiply dy du by du dx, which is the derivative of u with respect to x. And you can see that this constant of 2, the derivative is 0. So we're looking at the derivative of negative x, which is a negative 1. So simplifying, negative 1 times negative 1/2 is 1/2. So that's 1 all over 2 times, writing this exponent as a positive exponent, I'll put it in the denominator, so that'll be 2 times negative x plus 2 to the positive 1/2. Now when I plug in my value of negative 5 for x, I'll get 1 all over 2 times negative of negative 5, so the opposite of negative 5, plus 2 to the 1/2. That's going to equal 1 all over 2 times the opposite of negative 5 is a positive 5, and 5 plus 2 is 7, so that's 7 to the 1/2. But 7 to the 1/2 we can also write as the square root of 7. But remember, we don't want that radical in the denominator. So what we're going to do is multiply this entire quantity by 1, and that 1 is going to be square root of 7 over the square root of 7. So I'll get the square root of 7 all over 2 times the square root of 7 times the square root of 7, which is 2 times a positive 7, which is 14. So the square root of 7 over 14 is the slope of my function in number 8 at x equals negative 5. Now for number 9. In number 9, we have y equal to negative ln of negative x plus 2. So I'm going to set y equal to the negative ln of u, and u is going to equal negative x plus 2. So we're going to use the chain rule in order to solve. Although if you feel comfortable with the chain rule, feel free to do the chain rule in your head. Just make sure you write out your derivative so that if you have a mathematical error, you'll at least get partial credit for your steps. So the derivative of y with respect to u is the derivative of negative ln of u, which is negative 1 over u, which we know u is negative x plus 2, so that's negative 1 over negative x plus 2. So then du dx will equal the derivative of negative x plus 2, which is a negative 1. So dy dx equals dy du times du dx. So the derivative of y with respect to u times the derivative of u with respect to x, negative 1 times negative will be a positive, so that's 1 all over negative x plus 2. Now we're going to take that value of x, which is negative 3, and plug that in for x. So we'll have 1 over the opposite of negative 3 plus 2, which equals 1 over a positive 3 plus 2, which equals 1/5. So our derivative at x equals negative 3 is 1/5, and that's the slope of our function at x equals negative 3. And then lastly, we'll go over number 10. So we're going to take the derivative of the sine of u and multiply that by the derivative of 2x. So dy dx equals the derivative of the sine of u, which the derivative of sine is cosine of u. So we'll have the cosine of 2x times the derivative of 2x, which is times 2. So that's 2 times the cosine of 2x. And we're plugging in negative pi for x. So we'll have 2 times the cosine of negative 2 pi. And remembering our unit circle, negative 2 pi will have a cosine value of positive 1. So we'll have 2 times 1, which equals a positive 2. So in number 10, the slope of our function sine of 2x at x equals negative pi is a positive 2. And that wraps up this worksheet. If you want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below. Also, please feel free to like, subscribe, and share. If you want more ways to support me, become a patron. Go to my Patreon link to find out more, or go to maymap.com, maemap.com.